We've covered Chicago's City Key ID card, which is specifically designed to appeal to illegal immigrants. It was designed with them in mind, for them. The mayor of that city, Rahm Emanuel, has said so repeatedly. And yet, that card will also serve as valid ID for voter registration, which, of course, opens the door to illegal voting, which is the point. The city doesn't seem to care. In fact, as we just said, they're encouraging it. Austin Goolsbee is an economics professor at the University of Chicago, and he joins us tonight, and I think a friend of Rahm Emanuel's. So, Austin, thanks for coming on. So this seems like a challenge to the idea of democracy, which is that the people of the country, its citizens, ought to run the country. It seems like an invitation to foreign interference in our elections. And I don't think there's any misreading it. I mean, the city is issuing this to illegal aliens. They've said that out loud. They're not requiring proof of citizenship, obviously, to get it. And yet they're not requiring proof of citizenship at voter registration either. And this card is enough. So, like, there you have it. They're creating a pipeline to illegal voting, to voter fraud.
They aren't, Tucker. I'm your friend. Oh. And we have had many debates on immigration here. I think you're just confused. All an ID does is allow you to verify your identity, that you have the name that you say you have. It does not enable you, it does not make you eligible to become a voter, any more than if a non-citizen is serving in the military, they are issued a military ID. That is a valid form of government-issued identification that if they were a citizen, they could use it to register to vote. But we should not object to the military issuing a military ID.
But this actually isn't about, hold on, this is not about, it's not about the military. And there aren't a ton of illegals serving in the military either, by the, just as a factual matter. But here's the point. If I had this card and I'm here illegally, I'm a non-citizen. Maybe I'm here legally, but I'm still not a citizen. And I take it to register to vote in Illinois. What stops me from registering to vote? Oh, only self-reporting. That's it. There's no check.
You have to swear an oath. Look, in most states
of the
country,
have to say that you're allowed to vote. So in other words, the only thing stopping people from voter fraud is their own conscience? Is that what you're saying? I mean, like,
no,
tell me another.
It's that you commit a felony. It's that you commit a felony if you
swear. So if I leave a tray of Rolex watches on the sidewalk, and my view is, well, people can't take them, that would be a felony, should I really expect no one will take one?
There's nothing about Illinois that is distinctive about that. That is the case in almost all the states of the United States.
Oh, that they issue government ID cards specifically designed for illegal aliens?
No, that when you register to vote, you do not document your citizenship. You swear an oath that you are a citizen,
that you are a resident
of the precinct for 30 days,
and
not a felon.
There are only two states out of 50 that require proof of citizenship. But we spent the last year being lectured by the left about how foreign interference in our democratic process has hollowed out our democracy. I'm giving you a concrete example of how that could happen, and I believe is happening, where foreign
citizens— You're making a mistake.
Okay, but hold on. Why wouldn't we verify the citizenship of every voter? What's the answer to that?
The answer to that is because there are a large number of people, probably in the millions, who do not have that kind of citizenship. Only a third of the country has a passport. So you would disenfranchise
That's wrong. A third of the country... Those numbers are wrong. I do this for a living. I know that you're wrong.
35% of America has a passport. There are 110 million
passports. But it's not about passports. Hold on. It's not about passports. You can also bring a birth certificate. And if you don't have one, we can get you one. If you took the money that we spent on the city card ID and applied it to the people who don't have birth certificates and got them birth certificates.
Tucker, the city card ID is a subway card and allows you to check out library books. It does not give you the right to register to vote if you're not a citizen. That's not correct.
It allows you to.
It does not.
Hold on. Slow down.
It allows you to verify your identity only. That's all it does.
But just tell me again and speak slowly so I can, because, I mean, you're arguing in favor of voter fraud, and your party is making it possible.
You're not correct, Tucker. Homeless person. A homeless person cannot get a driver's license. They don't have an address. Okay. They can get one of these CityNet IDs. They have the right to vote in the United States. They okay. can use that and go down and verify
so
their
identity.
So let
me ask you this. Hold on. Let
if
me ask you this.
If they're not a citizen, they can't register to vote. That is a
but
felon.
Actually, they can. They're not allowed to, but they do. People are not allowed to rob liquor stores, but they do. I'm not sure if you're aware of that. They weren't allowed to be here in the first place, and yet they are. They broke our laws. So the onus is on us, if we care about the integrity of our elections, to do something to
then
make sure that only people allowed to vote
criminal
can.
Criminal court. Tucker, don't
let me
ban
ask you
these ideas,
let me, I have a real
which
question.
Are designed to allow people to check out books from the library to ride on the subway when they can't get a driver's license.
Look, that is not the point, and it's not the topic under discussion right now. The topic is,
that is
are we
the
making
point.
It easy
That's
for
why they
people
created
to vote?
These IDs.
So hold on. But now they're saying the IDs are valid for voter registration. So my question is, why don't we spend, and I'll contribute to it, a little bit of money verifying that everyone who votes, if we care about the sanctity of our elections, comma, which the Democratic Party does not, and we both know they don't, but if we're pretending we do, then why don't we make sure that they're citizens voting? Why not? Why not try that?
I understand that argument, and it would apply to 48 different states, not just to the city of Chicago.
I agree completely.
I believe
that the
reason we do not have a blanket rule of that is because of the fear that millions of legitimate citizens will have a onerous time. It will be difficult
for them. But
why
don't we help them? We just made a city card for illegals. Why don't we help our own citizens who don't have birth certificates? I'm confused. Why don't
look,
we make that
we
effort? Because we
that
don't
seems,
want.
That, look, we should. We should.
Oh, but
look
we're not even
those.
Trying
and
because we
should
want
prosecute
illegals
we
to
should
vote.
Prosecute to the full extent of the law.
You don't need to
anyone
prosecute
anyone that commits a felony.
No.
The city
you don't
card
need to prosecute
cannot
anyone.
Be used to make you eligible to vote. That's
it
not
it. Doesn't
correct.
Make you eligible to vote. It allows you to vote despite
correct.
The fact you're ineligible, which is
all
why
it allows you to do
the Justice Department will shut this down
that
tomorrow.
Your name is what you say it is. That's
right.
all
yeah.
it is. It's an
okay.
identification.
We're out of time. But I think on some level you know what I'm talking about. I know you do. Austin, thank you. Good to see you.
Hey, it's great to see you again, Tucker.
Thank you.